The beautiful hum behind us is an air conditioner, which is quite remarkable because we're standing outside at the Eureka Springs Farmers Market, and it is very hot, except for where I'm standing. And the air conditioning is by way of Jerry Landrum, who is here in his guise as the God of Power. He is providing all of the electricity for the Eureka Springs Farmers Market this morning. Jerry, welcome to the OHRH Harvest Radio Hour.
Oh, thank you very much, Dan. Good to see you again.
Okay. As I said, that background hum is an air conditioner. How is it happening? How is it that we have air conditioning here?
Well, it's just a small air conditioner for one, but it's a medium-sized solar system of about 2 kilowatts of solar PV that's producing around 20 amps at 50 volts, and right now the whole market, including the air conditioner, is using how much, Gary?
It's jumped up to 68 amps right now. It's been around 7 before that.
16,
is that what I said?
Yeah, so right now we're producing a little bit more power than what we're using, and the extra is going into a bank of eight batteries, so if a cloud comes by, the air conditioner stays on.
Okay, well, because we're on the radio, you're going to have to describe what's happening. You have hauled a solar power generator. Am I using the right words?
Well, it's just an off-grid solar system that I elected to mount onto a boat trailer, so that I could move it around, at my own property and put it where I want it, and also be able to do demonstrations and bring it over here to the farmers market. I've been planning this for some time.
Okay, so you have hauled it from Echo Green Village, I imagine.
Well, we're gonna let that be the Eureka Springs campus of the Homesteading University.
Okay.
And try to get that going.
All right. So you have hauled it from the Eureka Springs campus of Homesteading University to the farmers market here in Eureka Springs,
which is less than a mile,
and you have you're powering the entire farmers market this morning. Is that right?
Well, I think so. Plus, I've got a karaoke machine, a TV, 3 fans, a refrigerator, and the air conditioner.
Okay, good. And you have a sidekick with you here today. Can we talk with him? Is that all right?
Sure.
Hi, sir. Give us your name, please.
I'm Gary Milsark.
Hi, Gary. What are you doing here with Jerry Landrum?
Oh, well, I'm Jerry's fan and supporter.
Okay, good.
He's helped me with a number of gardening projects, and our travel trailer, we always thought we'd be hooking up, with hookups. We got what they said, if you're going to do that, get the cheapest battery you can find. And then we decided we were going to spend 9 days boondocking. So we needed a way to keep that battery up. And Jerry helped me out. We spent some hours, looking at alternatives. He bought a pallet of solar panels so that he could offer them at his cost to people less than they'd have to pay otherwise. So I bought a solar panel from him and a controller, and hooked it up to the tray, to the battery, and that kept us just totally fine for the 9 days out there in the sticks.
All right. Well, I am certainly enjoying this air conditioning, I have to say. Even though the hum may be annoying for our radio listeners, I love the fact that I am cool and I don't have all of that unsightly sweat dripping down my into my private part, so to speak. So, Jerry, what do you call this whole rig that we're standing in right now?
I call this Earth Burst. And if you see the graphic, one side of the trailer is covered by 8 foot tall by 13 foot wide. Basically, it's a retired billboard sign. This was actually had a prior life by advertising a Willie Nelson concert at the Biloxi Grand Hotel there in Biloxi, Mississippi. But on the other side is an Earthburst graphic, which is the features of the Earth mapped onto a heart-shaped map projection. And one of our local artists, Randy Russ, painted that for me. And it's try to kind of do a little bit of an art piece around the whole concept of the abundance.
Okay.
And the love.
All right.
Of Mother Earth. Uh-huh. And that we can work with the technologies to reinforce the love coming from Mother Earth.
All right.
Rather than detract and consume and exploit and extract.
Jerry, do you have an estimate of what this system cost you to create or build?
This is about an $8,000 to $9,000 system here.
Uh-huh. Yeah. And it'll fit on something the size of a boat trailer, and you can haul it wherever you need power.
Yeah, the array is actually about 10 feet by 16 feet.
Uh-huh. Okay.
And it's mounted on a 45 degree angle, so it fits on an 8 by 16 trailer pretty good.
All right. And how long does it take to put up and take down?
Just to take it and set it up and power the place where I live, doesn't take anything. I just drop this board, drop this shade down, and tie it off, and it's ready to go.
So in a matter of minutes, you, the new god of electricity and power, have provided electricity for the Eureka Springs Farmers Market.
I think it's mostly God doing all that.
We are talking with the very modest and very genial Jerry Landrum at the Eureka Springs Farmers Market, who has provided electricity with the help of God this morning, and through his own fine invention. We believe this may be the first farmers market in the United States that is entirely solar powered. Jerry Landrum, thank you so much for being our guest on the Ozark Harvest Radio Hour.
Thank you, Dan. Keep up the good work.
Volunteers at the Literacy Council have been teaching people in Carroll County to read and write for over 20 years. We teach basic literacy and English as a second language, as well as new programs in financial, health, computer, and family literacy. Please consider supporting us by passing along referrals of potential clients and students, becoming a friend of the Literacy Council, or, even more helpful, join with the First Christian Church, Carroll County Fresh, the Ozark Harvest Radio Hour, and It's a Mystery Bookstore as a sustaining sponsor. A special thank you to our newest sustaining sponsor, First National Bank of North Arkansas, whose main branch is on the downtown square in Berryville. You can reach us at our phone number, 870-505-1556. We'd be glad to talk to you about a sustaining sponsorship package. Or visit us at our website, www.carrollcountyliteracy.org, where we have a donation page with all pertinent information. And mainly, just keep us in mind. We're the Literacy Council, and we would love to help.
The following is a value statement which we've received from Andrew Swearin and Madeline Keenan by way of Local Harvest. It gives a simple, basic explanation of what the food movement is about. Here it goes. The best food is that which feeds body and spirit. This food can best be found at farmers markets, through a CSA, and in your own backyard. Cooking fresh, unprocessed food and sharing it with people you love is one of life's great pleasures. We support farms which place primary importance on building healthy soils, protecting the ecosystem, fair treatment of farm laborers, humane treatment of animals, and a sustainable life for the farmers. Protecting biodiversity on farms and seed saving are both good ideas. Genetically modifying crops is a bad idea, as is the current approach to farm subsidies. Local and regional food systems are of vital importance in this changing world and should be encouraged on every level. There's plenty of work to be done to strengthen and expand these systems, work in with which each of us can play a role. Onward!